Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, Jason here. In the previous Quickly Clarified episode, we went over what single scroll and twin scroll turbos are, along with their benefits and disadvantages. In today's video, we'll be going over what sequential and parallel turbo systems are, what are the differences, and what are their strengths and weaknesses. Before we get into today's video, I want to ask if you guys could please subscribe to the channel as it's free, it helps me out a lot, and if you guys don't enjoy my content, you can simply unsubscribe for free as well. Thanks guys! Anyways, on with the video. First of all, how does a turbo work? Basically, a turbocharger uses the exhaust gases coming out of the exhaust manifold to spin a turbine wheel connected to a compressor wheel that compresses air and forces air into the engine, otherwise known as boost. The bigger a turbo is, the longer it'll take to build boost, due to the heavier turbine and compressor wheels, or in other words, the more lag it'll have. This is why smaller turbos are usually preferred in economy cars, as they are more suitable for economy-focused engines. An inline 4 or 5 engine usually has just one turbo, whereas in bigger engines, ranging from 6 up until 16 or more cylinders, usually have 2, 3, or even 4 turbos. These multiple turbos can be arranged in two main methods, each of which has their own set of advantages and disadvantages. These two methods are named sequential or parallel setups. Now let's go through each one. Sequential turbos, also known as compound turbo systems, usually have different sized turbos, where there is a smaller turbo and a larger turbo. However, there are sequential turbo systems that have the same sized turbos, especially on the aftermarket scene. In a sequential turbo setup, when the engine is at low to medium RPM, the exhaust gases only flow into the smaller turbo in order to minimize lag. Then, once it reaches the mid to high RPM range, there is a valve that allows the gases to also flow into the larger turbo. However, some systems actually route the smaller turbo into the bigger turbo's turbine wheel, thus feeding the bigger turbo using the smaller one. Some examples of cars with a sequential setup are the Mark IV Toyota Supra, FD RX7, and Porsche 959, which happened to be the first car to use a sequential turbo setup. The advantage of sequential turbo setups are that they reduce turbo lag, improve throttle response, and provide smooth power delivery while also being able to produce plenty of power. However, the disadvantage of them is that they are much more complex, expensive, and tend to be less reliable and have less tuning potential in comparison to single or parallel turbo setups. Additionally, sequential setups are largely unused in modern cars thanks to new technologies to eliminate turbo lag, such as twin scroll turbos and variable geometry turbo technology that have pretty much removed the need for a sequential setup. Click here on the top right to see the previous video about single scroll versus twin scroll turbos, and please do subscribe if you would like to see me explain how a variable geometry turbo works in a future video. Speaking of parallel turbo systems, how do they work? The main difference is that parallel turbo systems work by having both or all of the turbos work together at the same time, splitting each turbocharger's load equally, unlike a sequential setup where the load is unevenly distributed between differently sized turbos. And instead of having a valve that controls when the other turbo kicks in, all of the turbos are working together simultaneously, removing the need for complex electronics that control when the turbos work. Usually on inline engines, the exhaust gases are split equally into each turbo, using an exhaust manifold. On V or W engines, the turbos are usually placed on the outside of each bank, where one turbo is tasked with the left bank and one turbo is tasked with the right bank. In engines with quad turbos, there would be two on each side. However, there is a new parallel turbo design that is becoming popular for V engines, where instead of the turbos being placed outside of the V, they are placed inside of the V in what is known as a hot V turbo setup. I'll explain about this in a later video, but regardless, parallel turbo setups significantly reduce the piping needed in comparison to sequential turbos as they are usually symmetrical and simpler. Some examples of cars with a parallel turbo setup are the Mercedes AMG C63, the R35 Nissan GT-R, and the Ferrari 488. Now, to end this video, let's recap the two setups' advantages and disadvantages. Sequential turbos usually have less turbo lag, have better throttle response, and have a smoother power delivery in comparison to parallel turbos. However, parallel turbos usually have less piping, are cheaper, less complex, and tend to be more reliable, as well as have bigger tuning potential in comparison to sequential turbo systems. This is why parallel turbo systems are much more common in modern cars, as there isn't much of a difference in lag thanks to the aforementioned technologies such as twin scroll turbocharging and variable geometry turbos. Anyways, hope you guys found this video helpful and entertaining at the same time. If you did, please do leave a like, And also please to subscribe as that helps me out a lot and it's also free. Other than that, comment down below if you have any video suggestions or critiques with this video. Either way, that's all for now. Stay safe and see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Maybe we can both explore this star is running.